Hey, hi everybody. How you doing? I'm Chris.
It's Nate.
This is First Warrior, the workup. Today we're going to talk about, we're talking more about sights. We're going to talk about canting your sight and the why that could be a good idea.
So, like we already said, we're going to make sure that the gun is unloaded, because all weapons are loaded until you can prove otherwise. So this firearm is unloaded. So we're just going to go into some options that you have. Like one of the other videos we stated, it's always good to have a backup sight just in case something is hit, something breaks, something falls off. There's any possibility that that primary sight could not function. With something like this, it has a 6X optic on it. You cannot put backup flip sights on this. They won't function. I can't get them to flip up, and they can't co-witness through a 6X optic. So one of the options that you do have would be canting the sight. These are just canted iron sights. So when I have the gun up, if for some reason my primary optic fails, I can cant the gun at about a 30 degree angle, and I have backup sights, which I've already sighted in, and
what
which
I want to
function.
Point out, real quick, not to interrupt you, but what I want to point out real quick is you barely change your stance at all. Like your stance barely changed at all. You just basically just tilted the rifle just a little bit. You didn't have to move anything significantly. You just barely just a tilt, and you're back on target.
The other option we have is something like this. This is one of the sights made by Swampfox.
It's called the Kingslayer sight. It's a micro reflex sight, and it just attaches on. It comes with a Picatinny rail. Just attaches right on the side of it, and it would be an option if you didn't have an iron sight on the side. You put something like this on there.
So these are made for the MOS Glocks, for the SIGs. They're small. They bolt right onto the top of the pistol, and it provides a better sight picture with the red dot than trying to acquire the equal height, equal light with your open sights, which we'll get into later. This sight actually does come with a Picatinny rail mount. So something you can also purchase, if you so desire, is a canted Picatinny rail, and you can mount this right on the side like this. So instead of having to use iron sights, you have a backup red dot. They also make mounts that go on the top of your rail mount cover where the red dot's on top. So instead of having to cant the gun, you can look right from the sight, right down this red dot, and have a whole nother sight picture for close quarters.
And I would say, what's the magnification of the scope you have right now?
6X.
So that's 6X. This is pretty much real time, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So that's going from I'm shooting something really far away to now I want to hit a target that's up closer. It's also the same thing. Just a quick loop, looking over to the side, and now you're right, real time, right in front of you.
And just something to add. This Swampfox Kingslayer is a 3-ohm MOA, which means it covers 3 inches at 100 yards of the target. They also make 6 MOA, which covers a broader spectrum, which is used for acquisition of targets at quick, where a 3-ohm MOA or a smaller red dot is actually for more precise precision shooting.